Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to do the revision of our geography subject. And the portion for our today's test is the earth and the graticule, and the second lesson, that is let us use the graticule. So now we will revise each lesson in short. Okay. So if you will see the second page of this lesson, then just see below this earth's diagram. They have given us here the length of the earth from the east to west direction. Okay, the length of the earth from east to west direction, how much it is? You can see here it is 12,756 kilometers, and the length of the earth from north to south is how much? 12,714 kilometers. So this is the distance of the earth from the poles and from east to west. So here you can understand or get an idea how big the size of the earth will be. Next, we have learned that, see here the highlighted point in the textbook, geographers developed a miniature model of the earth in the form of a globe. Understood? So whatever globe we use while studying geography, it is the miniature model of the earth. Yes, then we had seen about the next point, that is the angular distance. Okay, so here we had studied about angular distance. Yes, that the location of any place on the earth is determined with reference to the center of the earth. You can see here the first two lines. Yeah, any location, any place location, if you want to determine, then that is determined with reference to the center of the earth. Yeah, then later on we had studied about the parallels of latitude. So what are parallels, children? The horizontal lines, whatever you see on the earth, are called as parallels of latitude. Okay, so here you can see the circles thus created at some angular distance from the center of the earth are called as parallel to one another, and hence they are called as parallels of latitude. They are in this way. See, I'll show you on the screen like this. They are never intersecting. They have equal distance. There is equal distance between the two. So they are called as parallels of latitude. And value of each parallel is expressed in degrees. Okay. Now, then we had studied about the equator. Yeah. And we have studied that equator divides the earth into two parts, and that is called as northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Okay. And the poles. Okay. So the poles which are there, which appear like a point on the globe, are called as North Pole and South Pole. So now the next important point, what you should keep in mind about parallels of latitude, are we have total 181 parallels. How many parallels? 181. And they are at intervals of 1 degree. So 1 degree, 2 degree, 3 degree, 4 degree, if you will see, like this total we have 181 degrees, and there are 181 parallels. Now from that, at 0 degree, listen carefully, at 0 degree we have equator. Then above equator in northern hemisphere, we are having 90 parallels, that is from 1 degree north to 90 degree north. Okay. So here we have total 90 parallels in north. And then in southern hemisphere again we have 90 parallels. They are from 1 degree south to 90 degree south. Okay. So see, in total northern hemisphere 90 parallels in northern hemisphere. Okay. Then 90 parallels in southern hemisphere, and the center one 0. Or you can say in center we have 1. That is equator. Yes. So total we are having 181 parallels. Did you understand what to keep in mind about parallels? Parallels are horizontal lines, and in total we have 181 parallels, which are divided in northern hemisphere and in southern hemisphere. Later on we will study about, or we had studied about, meridians of longitude, isn't it? Meridians of longitude are the vertical lines. So if you will see an orange, one segment of orange, if you will remove, you can see it in this picture. If you will remove one segment of orange, how that segment is, same way we have longitude. So when you remove one segment of orange, that are the two main segments. See, for example, like this, we have longitude, vertical lines. In this way they show the longitudes. So is orange in this way only? So children, there, now the next thing that is here, vertical lines on the globe, which are imaginary lines, are called as longitudes. So one of the important longitude from all this is 0 degree longitude, or it is called as 0 degree meridian, which is also called as prime meridian. Okay, so now we will study about how much longitudes we have. So see the, in the yellow box here, instead of reading all this, we will just see here what we have to remember about the longitudes. In total we have 360 meridians. How much meridians? 360. And these meridians are also at the distance of 1 degree. Okay, so the main meridian, or the start of meridian, is from 0 degree meridian, which is called as 0 degree prime meridian. Now suppose this is 0 degree meridian, half circle. Other half, opposite to that, we have 180 degree meridian. Understood? So the second important meridian is 180 degree meridian. So here we got two meridians. The first one is 0 degree meridian, or 0 degree prime meridian, and second one is 180 degree prime meridian. Now this, are we getting a big circle? See, yeah? Suppose this is 0 degree and this is 180 degree. So did we get a circle? Now because of this circle, if you will think from the front side, then you will have like this. One front, other one will be back. If you will see, then the meridians, 0 degree meridian and 180 degree meridian, divides our earth again into two equal parts. That is called as a eastern hemisphere and western hemisphere. Okay? Now, in eastern hemisphere, we are having meridians from 1 degree east to 179 degree east. Okay, so total how many meridians we are having in eastern hemisphere? 179. And in western hemisphere we have meridians from 1 degree west to 179 degree west. So in west also we have 179 meridians. Now if you will add, see here, I'll show you. 179 in eastern part, 179 in western part, one is prime meridian and other one is 180 degree meridian. Yes or no? Total 9 plus 9, 18, plus 1, 19, 90 plus 1, 20, 7 plus 7, 14, plus 2, 16, and 1, 1, 1, 3. Did you get 360 as an answer? So children, we are having total 360 meridians, 179 at east, 179 at west, and the middle is 0 degree, opposite to that is 180 degree. Okay, so always remember there are 360 meridians and 181 parallels. Okay, now see, once again I'll tell you, parallels are in this way, horizontal way. So upper parallels are always given a sign like this, degree and north. And down parallels, how they are named? Degree and south. okay, whichever, if you are say look studying 10 degree, then you will say 10 degree south. If you are studying above the equator 10 degree, then you will say 10 degree north. Okay, so that degree, both are indicated in degrees, but always remember parallels are north and south, and meridians are in this way, east and west. So you can see here, they have written here 10 degree east, 25 degree east. So the meridians in the eastern part are given degree, they are also written in degree, but they are in eastern hemisphere, so E they are writing. The meridians in western hemisphere are labeled as 10 degree west, 25 degree west, 135 degree west. Understood here? Now, if you will see children, suppose we will consider 0 degree to 1 degree. In numbers, if you will see, then in between this also many numbers are lying that are fractions. Yes or no? In the same way, if you will imagine on our globe, our earth is very big. Okay, in 0 degree to 1 degree also there are many places. Then how to represent that places? To do that, see here, conventionally, see here, degrees are degree from 1 degree to 1, 0 degree to 1 degree, again there are many units. It is a big distance. Then that degrees are again divided into smaller units. What are those smaller units? See here, degrees are divided into minutes, and minutes are divided into seconds. See, I will explain it to you all. 1 degree is equals to 60 minutes. 1 minute is equals to 60 seconds. Okay, so 1 degree is divided into minutes, and minutes are divided into seconds. Now degrees, what did I say? Degrees symbol is half like this, upside you write 0, small 0. Like how do you show minutes? Like apostrophe, one apostrophe. And how do you show seconds? Like two apostrophes. You can see it in this, in your textbook also. They have given you how degree, symbols for degree, minutes and second. So always remember, 1 minute, 1 degree is equals to, see, I'll show you. Each degree means 60 minutes. Means what? 1 degree means is equals to 60 minutes. 1 minute is equals to 60 seconds. Okay. So did you understand about this? Now, we had to, one more thing we have to study, that is here, the distance between two adjacent parallels is how much? Suppose this is one parallel, I will use some other color. This is 10 degree and this is 19 degree. 19 degree and 20 degree, okay. Then distance between these two parallels is how much? 111 kilometers. Understood what did I say? Distance between two adjacent parallels is 111 kilometer. And also the distance between two adjacent meridian is 111 kilometers. Did you understand? Yeah. So always remember that parallels are horizontal lines and meridians are vertical lines. Distance between two parallels and distance between two adjacent parallels and two adjacent meridians is how much? 111 kilometer. There are total 181 parallels and 360 meridians. Next, what we had studied? 1 degree is equals to 60 minutes. 1 minute is equals to 60 seconds. Got it? Yes. Now, equator divides the earth into two parts, that is northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. and 0 degree and 180 degree meridian divides the earth into eastern hemisphere and western hemisphere. We had also seen the symbols or the symbols for degrees, minutes and seconds. Okay, now later on what we have learned. So students, we have studied that parallels are in horizontal way, yes, and they all are having same distance. And everywhere they have same distance, means whatever zigzag lines I drew between two parallels, you will have how much distance? 111 kilometer. Yes, then 0 to 1 degree, same distance. 1 to 2 degree, same. 3 to 4 degree, same distance in parallels. But children, in meridians, just see how are the meridians. Meridians are in this way. Yes or no? They are tapering towards the poles. What did I say? Meridians are tapering towards the poles. Now suppose this is an equator. If you will see distance, I am drawing blue lines here. This distance and here. Are the blue lines becoming smaller as I am coming near the equator? From equator the poles, if I will draw the lines in this way, are my blue lines becoming small, small, small? Yes. See, once again I'll show you. Only in one hemisphere I'll show. Here like this. Then little small. Is it becoming smaller and smaller? And up it is becoming like a point. Yeah. So children, see, the distance between two consecutive meridians. That two consecutive meridians I will show you in green color. This is one meridian and this is other. Two consecutive meridians is different at different places. You can see it is maximum near equator. So now I'll use pink color, yellow color. Maximum near the equator. So what is that distance? 111 kilometer. Okay, if you will go near Tropic of Cancer, you have studied that in second lesson. Where is Tropic of Cancer? Yes, there the distance is, suppose Tropic of Cancer is here, it is 102 kilometers near Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. If you will go near the Arctic Circle and Antarctic Circle, it is here and here, then the distance is 44 kilometer. And near the poles is it is 0 kilometer. You can see that green line is joining there. Yeah. So always remember, the distance between two meridians is maximum near the equator. And it goes on decreasing near the poles. So the last point what we are going to learn about, or what we are going to revise about this lesson, is the graticule. So here we have the picture of the graticule. You can see small squares are formed. That is called as a network. So the parallels and meridians on the globe form a net. That is called graticule. So this network is called as a graticule. Now what is its use? Its use is, or it is used for determining the location of a place. So if you want to know any place location on the earth, then we can make use of graticule. And we have understood it in the second lesson. Yes or no? We will revise it, but now just pay attention. Use of latitudes and longitude is for determining the location of a place on the earth. Yes, and in today's world we are using it. How we are using it? Well, quite effectively we are using it. Yes or no? So we are making use of geographical information system, that is GIS, GPS. Yes or no? Also Google Maps, Wikimapia, Bhuvan, all these things we are making use, which are available on internet, and that helps us to locate a place on the earth. Yes, so these are some of the important points which are necessary from this lesson, and this will also help you for your test. Okay, so listen to the video carefully and understand it.